All action from Nastyukhin, the veteran.
I'm so glad this is the first fight of the night.
It's a perfect way to kick off one on Prime Video 2. Zhang versus Lee 3. Two world title fights to come. Five fights in all on this main card, and we start off with a crack.
Nastyukhin already threatening the level changes, looking to possibly wrestle here with Halil Amir. I like that strategy. But Halil Amir, I think he does like to close that distance, Nastyukhin, and then get into the clinch and then look for the takedown. Nice little redirection there from Halil Amir.
Halil Amir looks strong. He looks big and strong. He's able to get his back off the fence right away. He's got Nastyukhin against the fence.
These are the body, three of them there from Halil Amir.
Let's see if Nastyukhin can work something here. He's got to try to, you know, change those levels, mix things up a little bit if he gets Halil Amir pressed up against that cage like that.
Opening minute, 3-5 in rounds. Again, this judged as a whole instead of round by round. Wild left there, the hook.
That's really important for Halil Amir, is when Nastyukhin starts to come forward with those hooks to circle out and not put his back against the wall, because that's where Nastyukhin likes to crowd people and then start doing that dirty boxing with those close range hooks.
It's interesting footwork coming from Halil. He's a southpaw and he's circling around to his backside and to Nastyukhin's power side.
Yeah, Nasty's trying to pin him right there against that wall. Nice little right hand connects, but it's that good little sidestep there. Circled away from the fence to get his back off the wall and then take control of the center circle.
Nice escape by Amir. Back to the center of the one circle. 2 minutes into this opening round.
Nice jab from Halil.
We'll defend the kick there from Nastyukhin. And fire a straight left. Out of that southpaw stance, Halil Amir, the newcomer to one championship. Inside leg kick, Nastyukhin.
I think that's going to be important.
Nice
weapon
one,
for
two.
Nastyukhin is to throw that inside leg kick, start damaging the legs of Halil Amir, because Halil's got good footwork and the way that he's creating those angles.
He does have good footwork. It's interesting. He picks times where he's choosing to go to the power side of Nastyukhin and then times where he's choosing to go the opposite direction to the lead.
It's modified Taekwondo footwork, right? It's not quite as wide and as bladed as usual Taekwondo, but he is definitely has sort of hints of that Taekwondo style in there.
Nastyukhin trying to cut off the angle. Closes in, got him against the fence. Big left hook to the head.
I like those knees though. Firing those knees right up the middle from Amir when Nastyukhin tries to close that distance.
This vertical stance from Halil, I hope this doesn't come back and haunt him later on in this match. I'd like to see him getting his chin down a little bit more and making sure that he's getting that head offline.
You know, besides all the trash talking that Amir was doing, he did actually have some really good points about trying to get this match into the later minutes, because he feels that Nastyukhin isn't going to be the same Nastyukhin as he is in the first five.
He said that Timofey swings wildly and gasses out. That's also part of the excitement of this man.
Those are your words or Halil's words?
His. Don't put them on me.
But it's controlled chaos, right? He does have wild hooks and he does throw big power punches, but there's a method to the madness, right? Like, he's trying to really take your head off of your body with precise, accurate shots.
You know, after watching Nastyukhin's matches with Doggy, I don't see gas as being a problem with him. He throws big and he might utilize a lot of energy on his strikes, but at the same time, he's typically very calculated on when he explodes or when he expends that energy.
But it wasn't just Doggy too. Like, he showed, you know, he could go long against Peter Baust, right? There's that takedown though. Right? And that's what a perfect timing on it, right? As the first five is about to come to an end, he was able to score a takedown and then has Halil Amir on the run.
Got caught up on the post there on his way out. No harm, no foul. Final 30 seconds, straight right coming from Nastyukhin.
Yeah, that one just barely grazed if it touched him at all. I don't like the way that Nastyukhin is standing in range here and allowing Amir to work that inside leg kick.
Well, especially because he's so explosive off of that lead leg. You know, everything that he does is a big explosion, whether he's coming forward throwing punches or he's looking for that takedown. To do work on that inside lead leg is a good idea. Nice little back kick.
And that's the end of round one. Good close to it for Halil Amir. All action, as expected in this first round of the main card.
There's Doggy throwing four punches to enter something inside the clinch. Good head movement showcased by Amir as he comes forward. And he just starts beating up that inside leg kick. I like that strategy here in the first five. But then there's those knees, right? They're not big, right? They're not big motions, but they're nice little touches, right? That was a beautiful big touch right there as Nastyukhin came crashing forward looking for those punches into the double leg, tried to advance his position, but then nice little get up from Halil Amir.
Yeah, you can see here, I was actually looking up the corner here. You can see it on camera now, the wear on the face of Halil where some of these big shots from Nastyukhin has landed.
Yeah, Nastyukhin will tattoo you.
Singapore Indoor Stadium. Incredible way to start off this main card, the first of five bouts. Two world title fights to come later tonight. This in the lightweight division, Nastyukhin, the number three contender against the newcomer Halil Amir from Turkey.
Halil's being a little bit more aggressive with that right hand, trying to lead with it, but he's only just throwing that big right hand. He needs to put some more things behind it or in front of it. Good catch from Nastyukhin as he charges forward. Nice little hook.
He got a hand from me. Timofey on his feet. He's in trouble, and that takes a knee to the head. Under siege is Nastyukhin firing lefts. Halil Amir finally Nastyukhin to his feet, but he's in trouble. Back down he goes. Heavy rights, heavy artillery from Halil Amir. Nastyukhin is trouble.
Nastyukin's still trying to say he's okay, but he's wobbled.
Nastyukin's done. Halil Amir. What an entrance into one championship for the man from Turkey.
When he smelled blood, he went in for the kill.
He just took out the number three ranked lightweight contender, ladies and gentlemen.
Halil Amir,
8-0, real deal. Wow.
A 100% finishing rate. And now seven of his eight wins by knockout. He is the real deal in the lightweight division, and he's going to be a big problem going forward. They were both rocked, but Timofey in particular was out on his feet there.
You can see Timofey comes in with that heavy right hand. Halil steps back, catches him with two hooks, but it was the second hook that really did the damage. Had Nastyukhin doing the chicken dance there. And once he smelled blood, he was all over it. You can't give a guy like Nastyukhin time to recover because he is, if there's any fighter, Nastyukhin is the guy who could actually survive from this. So this was smart by Halil.
Tom Lau to make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Herb Dean, has called a stop to this contest after 58 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout!